Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to Mustang Bronco Basketball. You are looking live here at the court at Edmond North High School as your Mustang Broncos are getting set to take on the Edmond North Huskies in this regional championship matchup. Winner of this game punches their ticket into area with no losses. It's a good place to be. So I'm Ryan Booth, voice of the Broncos, excited to be with you here again tonight live on MHSBroncosports.tv. Bronco Basketball brought to you tonight by Oral Surgery Specialists of Oklahoma. Located at 4320 Macaulay Boulevard in Oklahoma City. At Oral Surgery Specialists of Oklahoma, oral surgeons and periodontists combine their expertise to serve you and all of your oral surgery needs. You can check them out online and get more information at OklahomaCityOralSurgery.com. And this is the Mustang Social Energy and Nutrition Pregame Show. Mustang's spot for nutritional energy-based teas and shakes and so much more. Located at 1036 East State Highway 152, right in the heart of Mustang. It's Mustang Social Energy and Nutrition. And they get the stamp of approval from the Mustang ladies basketball team as they were all there at Mustang Social earlier today. And, hey, it must have worked out because hopefully you were with us earlier this afternoon as you saw Mustang defeat UConn 48-42 on the Miller's home court to take that regional championship game. So the girls are on to area, and if you look at it, a familiar foe awaits the Broncos. It'll be Edmond North. That game will be Thursday at either 6 or 7:30. Game time and location still to be determined. Probably won't know that until Monday or Tuesday of next week after everything gets settled here in regional play, because there'll still be regional games going on tomorrow for those teams that have fallen down into that regional consolation bracket, both on the girls and the guys' side. But again, a huge win earlier this afternoon for Mustang over the longtime rival UConn Millers. And I said it during the broadcast and I'll say it again. Hey, there was nothing sweeter than with about, just a little bit less than a minute left on the clock, you look down at the UConn student section, and what do you see? You see a lot of surrender Cobra positions and a long line of students heading for the exits. So it was a good day over in UConn. Hopefully, we can see something like that here tonight. It has been a tough road for anybody that has tried to take on the Edmond North Huskies. Mustang comes into tonight's game 14-9 overall. And as I look down their schedule, December 12th at Edmond North, it was a 61-42 loss against Edmond North. February 2nd at home, it was a 65-46 loss to Edmond North. So Mustang 0-2 against the Huskies this season. But hey, you never know. You've still got to play the game. Coach Hodges and the guys playing pretty well here their last couple games. If you were with us last night, you saw them really grind out a big win, 54-50 over Putnam City West, who beat Lawton Eisenhower in the game earlier this evening here at Edmond North to continue on in regionals. So Ike is out. Putnam City West will move on, and so their hopes at moving into area still alive. For Mustang, again, you win this one and you move on. If not, then you are looking at, as I look down the bracket here, game 17. So you drop down and you will play the winner of Putnam City North Northwest Klassen. That game is going on down in Lawton. So Mustang will actually have to travel to Lawton tomorrow if they lose this one. But hey, let's just not have to worry about heading down the turnpike to Lawton. Let's just go ahead and come into Edmond North's house and steal one here tonight and just give everybody give Saturday off to just sit back, relax, and enjoy some of this beautiful weather that we have been having. But about 3.5 minutes away from tip-off here on the Mustang Social Energy and Nutrition pregame show. Take a look back real quick at last night's game. Again, 54-50 the final. And really the player of the game in my eyes, and if you talk to Coach Hodges, because Mustang basketball put it on their Twitter last night, their prime time player was Michael Vincent. You look at his stat line and you're like, well, now how is that? 5 points, 4 rebounds. but all four of those rebounds came late when Mustang was either just trailing by a point or two, or once they had taken the lead, and they were big defensive rebounds to keep Putnam City from getting second chance opportunities. So Michael Vincent, big defensive playmaker late in the game, a couple of block shots as well, and really just did a good job on the interior where most of the night Putnam City West had had the advantage. So they had a couple big guys, Wilson and Rayfield. When those two guys were both in the game at the same time, it gave Mustang some troubles. But foul trouble, and Putnam City West had to kind of shuffle their lineup just a little bit. Rayfield, the star for PC West, 21 points. But going back to the defensive effort out of Vincent and some other guys, he was held scoreless in the fourth, and Mustang only surrendered 6 points in the fourth quarter, and they needed every bit of that as they came from behind again to win 54-50. JT Johnson played a lot of defense on Rayfield. Rayfield had him by a good 6-7 inches in the height-wise, but when Cole Clipson was occupied having to guard Miller for Putnam City West, it just took a group effort to try and keep Rayfield from just totally dominating, and down the stretch, Mustang did a really good job. JT finishes with 8 points. Tyson Pogai had 11 points, 4 rebounds, 2 steals, initiated the offense really well, moved the ball, did a good job just kind of staying, keeping things in control and keeping the guys steady and level out on the floor. Jaden Johnson and Roman Miller, 14 points apiece. So Roman only had 3 points in the first half, so he puts 11 on the board in the second half and did a good job. Earned a number of trips to the free throw line and went 7 of 8. So a good all-around game once again from Roman Miller last night. So tonight it's a different animal. It is Edmond North, the 2-time defending state champion, looking to be the first team to three-peat. So, and crazily enough, same thing over on the girls' side with head coach Pete Paparonis and the Edmond North Lady Huskies. They're the 2-time defending state champion, and they are looking for a three-peat. And really, you've got, like the legendary wrestler Ric Flair says, hey, if you want to be the man, you got to beat the man. And this is the team that you've got to beat if you want to continue on down that road. So, again, ticket punched by one of these teams here tonight into the area tournament. So Mustang visitors tonight in the road black uniforms. Once again, starting lineups being introduced. We'll give those to you as they are announced. But my guess for Mustang is probably going to be 0, JT Johnson, 1, Tyson Pogai, 3, Jaden Johnson, 23, Roman Miller, and 34, Cole Clipson. So far, I'm 1 for 1. So sophomore number 0, JT Johnson. Freshman number 1, Tyson Pogai. Another sophomore number 3, Jaden Johnson. A junior number 23, Roman Miller. Yep, and big number 34, the senior, Cole Clipson. That'll be the 5 that'll start here tonight for Coach Hodges. Again, it'll be Johnson, Pogai, Johnson, Miller, and Clipson. So now the starting lineups will be introduced for Edmond North. Edmond North trying to get their hype video going, and there it is. So again, Edmond North, you look at them, they come into tonight's game with an overall record of 19-3. 2 of those losses Rover at the Bass Pro Tournament of Champions, a number of nationally ranked teams in that tournament. And then the 1 loss in the regular season, and it nothing against Moore, just a little bit of a head scratcher on that one. You look at it, 61-42. So not only did they lose, but they lost big. But that was kind of a wake-up call, because after that, their final 3 games of the season, Edmond North just dominated Capitol Hill, Piedmont, and Edmond Santa Fe to head into postseason. So getting the start here tonight, senior number 1, Tatum Ridge. Senior number 2, Keontae Tramble. another senior guard, number three, Dontrell Yearby. Senior number 23, Dylan Warlick. And another senior, number 32, Bryce Potts. So you sense a, or you see a familiar theme in their starting lineup. Senior, 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 senior. A very senior-laden team. And again, a lot of experience. It's been a tough matchup for Mustang. Edmond North, they pretty much can do it all. They can get up and down the floor. They can grind it out. They can play physical. They can, they're extremely athletic, even for guys with a lot of size. So Mustang once again will have their hands full tonight here in this one. But hey, you never know what's going to happen. That's why they play the game. And we are underway here at Edmond North. Ball's up in the air, tipped out. And it was, yeah, they pointed in the way of Edmond North. But the way the ball flew out, it went back in the direction that they were slapping it. So officials get together, come to an agreement that they say, no, they're going to give it to Mustang. And right there you see the defensive pressure from Ridge out top on Johnson. So he knocks that one out of bounds. So Tyson has it now over on the side to JT. Roman looks to drive, floats it over to Tyson. Tyson and Yearby, that'll be a good matchup here tonight. Two quick, athletic guys that both really just stay calm. Said that a lot about Tyson. You wouldn't know if you were just watching him and not looking at anything else, if he'd scored 50 or if he hadn't scored any, if Mustang was up or down by 50. Just calm, cool, and collected. Three-pointer up on the way, a little bit strong from Jaden Johnson. And North clears the rebound. And we'll get their first chance to put points on the board. Warlick has it down low, long three by Yearby, and that one falls through. So Yearby opens the scoring here tonight, 3-0. Edmond North. Pogai with it. He works off a Cole Clipson screen. Good job there by Potts to get out and give his teammate time to recover. Roman up top, Tramble on him. Roman spins down, looks to go to work. Now he's double-teamed, kicks it out. Three ball on the way. Again, just a little bit strong off the hands of Jaden Johnson. 0 for 2 now. Quickly in transition. Maybe he had it for a second. Warlick has it. Again, that one goes through the legs of Potts. But they're going to say it's because Cole was holding him, didn't let him go down and get that one. For Edmond North, what really just gets everything started is the ball doesn't stick. They know, they get it, they look, if there's not a shot or a driving lane, they just move it on to the next man in line. Rebound up, and you could hear that one down on the floor. Ridge was fouled. Let's see who's going to pick this one up. Cole, that was Cole's first. Roman Miller's going to pick that one up. Warlick gets deep in the paint and just flips that one up and in. You cannot let him get down there. Strong, strong young man right there, and he is not going to be denied when he gets that close to the rim. But again, yeah, for Edmond North, they just move the ball well. Everybody's moving, lots of action. They force you to play defense the entire time. Nice find by Roman as Edmond North lost Cole there in the middle of the lane, and Cole makes him pay. First basket of the night for Mustang. And it's 5-2. Warlick, good ball fake. Roman kind of caught Warlick as he was going by. So, and if these officials, same officials from the game we saw a lot of before this one here between Putnam City West and Lawton Eisenhower, and they really let the two teams play, again, within the flow of the game, nothing, you know, out of control or anything like that. Just let these guys play, and the three is good for Tramble. And as he flew out at him, Johnson clipped him on the arm. So it's going to be the unconventional four-point play opportunity for Tramble. So third foul on Mustang. And Johnson just maybe a little bit out of control on that one. But again, you got to close out. He at least tried to flash at him, get that hand up, but unfortunately caught him. So free throw was missed. And then an offensive foul. It's going to be the second one. So here in the span of about 10 seconds, foul on Jaden Johnson. He picks up his second and the team's fourth. Down low it goes, and now an offensive foul. I think they're going to get Potts clearing out. That's how. Yeah, Potts clearing out, and that's why there was so much room for Warlick to go to work down low. Vincent checks in. So Johnson will go to the bench. So Pogai with it. Cole up top. Vincent along the baseline again. Just played so good last night defensively. Roman a little crossover, step back three, won't go. Johnson up for the rebound, dumps it down to Cole. Reverse layup, won't go. Vincent had it, and then as he put it back up, he was fouled. And it was things like that last night that. So Potts picks up his second personal foul. Potts, the big 6'6 senior for Edmond North. But I was going to say, they'll either bring in 6'6 junior Logan Knoll or 6'7 senior Xavier Ross. So not going to lose anything in the size column when Potts comes out, because the two guys that usually come in for him. So free throw's good, 8-4 halfway through the first quarter here again in this regional championship matchup. He swings it over all alone as Yerby couldn't connect on that one. Pogai with the rebound. He gets into the lane, a little running one-hander off the glass and in. And just Pogai turns the corner and just holds that ball out there. It looks like a waiter taking an order to the table. But again, if they try to get after it, chances are he's going to get fouled, because he's using his body to shield, protect that basketball. So long straightaway three, won't go. Rebound tipped up. Had it for a second, did Knoll. And now Mustang with it after that miss. Right up the floor, out to the wing. Tyson for three, got it. Pogai rises, fires, and it falls from long range, and Mustang has their first lead of the night, 9-8. So again, nice transition basketball, finding the open shooter down in the corner, or out on the wing, I guess more. Good defensive recovery. This one, and another offensive foul. Knoll's going to pick this one up on the moving screen.
Yep.
So Knoll picks up his second, third team foul now on Norman North. So it was 4-0 real quick on fouls, and now it's starting to even up a little bit, 4-3. Down to about 2.5 here in the quarter. A little give-and-go action. Roman into the lane. Draws all the defenders to him, and Clipson right there to put it up and in, and Mustang up 11-8. And Edmond North, head coach Scott Norris, wants a quick Jay Willis auto body timeout here, as Mustang's got a little something cooking in this one. So it's a, I didn't see if it was a 30 or a full. We'll say it's going to be a quick one, so we'll step aside.
OU Health's ER and Urgent Care is now open with two convenient locations in both South Oklahoma City and Yukon. You get the convenience of an urgent care and all the expertise of an ER under one roof, and you only pay for the level of care you need. To learn more, visit www.ouhealth.com/oneroof. In-network with most major insurance providers, including Medicare and Medicaid.
Back to action here at Edmond North after that Jay Willis Auto Body timeout. A full-service body shop. Hey, check them out online at jwillisautobody.com to see how they can help you with all of your auto body needs. So Roman, a couple assists here early in this one. Nice job down low. Clipson goes straight up, but there you can see just how strong Dylan Warlick is. Cole's all over him, and he does exactly what you should. Goes right into the body of the shot blocker, of the defender down there. So Cole's got 4 points, and he's made himself available down low. Again, had a couple nice baskets as whoever, like one time it was Roman, but yeah, Bronco driving down the lane, draws the defenders to him. Cole's played big. Guys did a good job to find him. Roman, long three, rims out. Warlick in for that rebound. Vincent was there to challenge, but Dylan got his both big paws on that one. So tied at 11. Mustang takes it away. 2-on-1. Roman sidesteps. And a whistle and a foul from the trail official as he was bumped. Landon Fitzgerald. Yeah, Fitzgerald got him. Maybe a little bit of a late whistle. It kind of caught me off guard. The way it's been going, watching that girls game earlier today, I thought maybe we were going to have a travel call. And Coach Price is definitely giving one of the officials a little bit of his thoughts on the matter. So Jaden Reyes checks in. Clipson will go out. Roman knocks down the two free throws. And Mustang back on top now by two. Swing it over, nice ball fake. Again, good ball movement, but great defensive rotation by Mustang. And then losing the handle is Parker Mitchell. No, sorry, that's two. Keontae Tramble, as it was zero. Johnson, JT Johnson, that had closed out on him. So a couple Huskies thought they were going to have open looks, but good defensive rotation by Mustang shut that down. And then the turnover. So, and Reyes is going to pick up the foul as he had gone to set the screen. And, man, Yerby just had a full head of steam and plowed right through. The officials telling Coach Hodges that Reyes was in one spot and then tried to slide over underneath. So, and that contact's not going to bother Reyes. And there you see the size once again. This time it's Xavier Ross at 6'7". Miller along the baseline, down deep underneath, has his shot blocked from behind. Vincent collects the miss, and then just too tight there on the sidelines, trying to thread that one over to Tyson, and it goes out of bounds. So 13 all, under 30 seconds to play here in the first quarter. Down in the corner, three is short. Miller skies for the rebound, keeps it. Pogai, a little hesitation dribble along the baseline. Nice trail. Secondary break by Vincent, just trails the play, gets right into the lane, just a little handoff underneath. Long three is up, in and out, and then tipped up and in by Fitzgerald. Fitzgerald just outworked everybody else. He snaked his way right in between a couple Mustang defenders, and then a whistle and a foul. JT Johnson, I never heard the whistle, but everybody stopped. Yeah, JT picks up his first. And that free throw, it was almost, I was going to say that free throw gives Edmond North a lead, and it was almost a short-lived lead as Tyson from way on this side of half court came pretty close to knocking that one down. So 16-15 at the end of one. We'll take a timeout and be back with the second quarter. You're watching Bronco Basketball, brought to you by Oral Surgery Specialists of Oklahoma.
Our mission here at Oral Surgery Specialists of Oklahoma is to provide exceptional care to our patients in a warm and welcoming environment.
We enjoy creating an exceptional experience for our patients with belief in patient education, careful listening, and customized treatment planning.
Here at Oral Surgery Specialists of Oklahoma, we uniquely offer a full scope of oral surgery and periodontal services under one roof, including dental implant placement, wisdom teeth removal, gum grafting, and jaw surgery.
We love what we do here, and we look forward to the opportunity to be able to care for our patients and provide exceptional oral surgery and periodontal surgery.
Back with you, ladies and gentlemen. Second quarter just about ready to get started. So Tyson Pogai, the leading scorer for Mustang in quarter number one with 5 points. Roman Miller, 2 points, but two big assists. His 2 points coming off of free throws. Clipson, 4 points, and Vincent, 4 points. So that's 8 points down low for Mustang. And, again, that's something that against a team like Edmond North is big because they're playing against a lot of size. So Warlick called for 3 seconds in the lane. So turnover, Edmond North gives it back to Mustang. Trailing by one, just underway here in the second quarter. Roman looks to go to work. He's still guarded by Tramble. Roman spins, almost spins into a double team, has to get rid of it before he's called for a travel as he got up in the air. Step back three off the mark, but nobody blocks out Vincent into the lane. And then off a couple hands, and Pogai doesn't give up on the play and pokes it away as I think Yerby was starting to think about how he was going to put some showtime into his finish. And that allowed Tyson to come from behind and steal that one away. Pogai, corner three, just off the mark. Vincent tips it out, and it stays alive. So Vincent picking up where he left off last night. That's exactly what he did. Nice little sidestep into the lane. Roman's hacked in the act on the way to the rack. Can't get it to go, but he will toe the line for two. Ross picks up the foul, his first and the first team foul here in the quarter. Roman gets that one to go. So Roman's up to three now, and they've all come from the free throw line. Noel back in the lineup as Ross will have a seat. Roman's second free throw is good. Yerby with it down in the corner, wanting to get it into Warlick, but Michael Vincent doing a great job just denying anything down low. So Pogai, eyes Ridge, who decides, well, I'll just put it up and see what happens, and he rattles that one in. Wasn't pretty, but it went. Vincent up top. Reyes into the lane. Step back three for Johnson. Again, just off the rim, and Vincent and Reyes just in there doing all they can to try to knock that out. Three in the corner is off the mark. And Reyes had it for a second. And then Reyes flying in, and he was just shoved to the floor. So I didn't see who it was, but Reyes was just running, and the next thing you know, he's flying like in the opposite direction. So Warlick with 7 points, a 30-second timeout taken. We'll step aside one more time as well.
Oakey Print Barn is a proud sponsor of Mustang Athletics. For the best in custom apparel, contact Oakey Print Barn today. Oakey Print Barn, your hometown screen printer located on Highway 152 in Mustang. Let's go Broncos!
Jay Willis Auto Body, the official sponsor of all Bronco basketball timeouts. And in less time than it takes for a timeout, the team of experts at Jay Willis Auto Body can get you back on the road. You can check them out online at jaywillisautobody.com or, hey, get in touch with them the old-fashioned way. Call them 405-261-6655. Johnson drives the baseline, gets it to Pogai. So Mustangs had some good looks. That three ball up, again, just a little bit strong. Johnson gets the rebound and able to dribble out of trouble. And all the Mustang fans collectively holding their breath. And then a whistle. And I think we're going to have an offensive foul. It's called Roman for hooking. So an offensive foul on Roman for hooking. And the thing with Roman, man, where Edmond North is doing a good job, Roman gets into the lane. They're anticipating that spin to the open, to the off hand, and just somebody's just coming over and crashing him and cutting that off. And just like that, that three ball from Tramble makes it a 7-point lead. So just when you think, and again, Roman just, I'll say it, mugged on his way to the basket, and no whistle. And then a foul is going to be called as Warlick tries to put it back up and in. And Coach Hodges is saying, hey, look, my guy was accosted on his way to the rim. Nobody even thought about blowing a whistle. And then on that, we get a call. And, I mean, Warlick got fouled. I mean, there was three guys there. Unfortunately for Mustang, it does go against Roman Miller. So 26-17, back up top, Johnson for three, got it. That one goes for JT Johnson. Maybe that'll help get the lid off the basket for him. It's a 6-point game, just right at 4 minutes to play here in the quarter. Down low it goes, and again, just I'm at a loss for words. As Warlick went from the block to under the rim, never dribbled the basketball, just kept backing in, and no travel. And then on the second chance opportunity, and hey, keep doing it. If they're not going to call it, just keep playing. So a whistle and a foul, and I believe that was on Vincent. So, in a little bit of foul trouble starting to mount for Mustang. Warlick, 5 of 5 from the free throw line. He's got 11 points, so he's now into double digits after he connects on those two. Clipson with it way outside. Hands it off to Tyson. Pogai looks to drive. Spins into the lane. Johnson goes up, but not strong enough, has his shot blocked. 2-on-1 break, trying to alley-oop it to Warlick, but way off the mark. They lose it out of bounds, so it'll go back to Mustang. So 28-20, as much of a struggle as it's been the last couple minutes for Mustang, it could be a lot worse because Edmond North started to get hot. Roman on his drive as it knocked away, but they're going to say last touch by Miller, so Mustang will give it right back to North. Warlick down on the corner. Now they switch it off to Roman. Again, couple spin moves, stripped on his way up. And then Johnson's pushed down from behind in transition. Pogai misses the shot. It's poked away. Ball still loose. And now North has it. Going to the rim is Ridge. And he lays it up and in because Roman can't risk picking up another foul. So he challenges as much as he can. But it's not enough. And it's a 10-point deficit now facing Mustang. It's a Jay Willis Auto Body full timeout. We will step aside as well with Mustang in a little bit of trouble here in this one.
Joe Cooper Ford has three Ford dealerships around the metro to serve Oklahoma better than anyone else. What does having three of the best Ford dealerships in the state mean for you? It means three times the selection and three times the savings, and that's three times the service. And Joe guarantees to beat any price in Oklahoma by $500, or he'll give you $10,000. That's why Joe beats the competition 3-1. I love you, Oklahoma.
Hey Bronco fans, this is Larry Andrews with 777 Roofing and Construction. We're proud supporters of the Mustang Broncos. Go Broncos!
Again, Bronco basketball would like to thank our title sponsor, Oral Surgery Specialists of Oklahoma. And right now, Mustang's just got to try to get some things figured out really on both ends of the floor. So offensively, they've had some good looks, just shots not falling. But for every open shot they've had two just highly contested shots. So and then on the other end, here the last couple times, Edmond North's been able to get out in transition and kind of get going downhill with a full head of steam. Pogai into the lane, kicks it out. Johnson for three. Got it. JT Johnson knocks down his second three-pointer of the night. So he's got two from about that same spot now. So he may have found his spot on the floor. Driving in the lane, trying to dump it down. No-look pass. But it wouldn't go. Johnson right to the rim. Too hard off the glass. But he hustles back. Warlick looks to drive. Everybody collapses in the lane, left Tramble wide open outside. He decided to drive. And then again, Mustang just can't gather up the loose ball. And they're going to say Cole was out of bounds when he got it. So it'll give it back to North. Again, a minute and a half to play here in the second half. And Warlick just looked like he didn't want to go after that one. And he was trying to say that it was touched by Mustang, but wasn't anybody close enough to Dillon to touch that basketball. So Mustang will get it back, only trailing by seven. Again, as much of an uphill battle as it's been. Tyson drives, wild shot off the mark, won't go. And again, quickly in transition. And again, Roman tries his best but can't challenge too much. And Tramble gets the easy finish. Roman little jumper off the mark, too strong. And again, drive into it. Ridge just lays it up and in, and Clipson picks up the foul. That's three now on Clipson, with under a minute to play here in the second quarter, and Cole's got three. So now it's a 12-point game. Mustang had it down to seven, so a 5-0 run. Long three, a little bit strong. Johnson gets the rebound from the brothers' miss. Vincent had it for a second, but then lost it. and an offensive foul. They're going to say Warlick kind of cleared out to get that, as that was just kind of a mess from the start. A long outlet pass. His first, team's second is all here in the quarter. So, yeah, that one was thrown up the floor, nobody looking. Then it just turned into a scramble all the way around to try to get it. So 20 seconds left. Mustang probably going to be content to try to just bleed this down and just get something on the board. You'd like for it to maybe be a three and get it to single digits. Long shot put up by Pogai. I'm not sure. Still had about 4 or 5 seconds on the clock when he let that one fly. So that one came up short off the front of the rim. So Warlick will put it up at the buzzer, and that one, it would have counted if it went, but it pinballed out. And Edmond North goes on a run here in the second quarter to pull away from Mustang. What was a tight game is now opened up to a double-digit lead for Edmond North, 35-23, as we head into the locker room. So we'll take a timeout. We'll get some of the first half stats, and we'll be back with you here in just a few minutes for all the second half action. You're watching Bronco Basketball, brought to you by Oral Surgery Specialists of Oklahoma.
Discover authentic Italian cuisine at Emma L's in West OKC, featuring freshly prepared Italian favorites. Everything made to order. Dine in or get it to go. Emma L's Italian Kitchen, Kilpatrick Turnpike and 39th Expressway. Let us do the cooking.
Hey Bronco fans, this is Larry Andrews with 777 Roofing and Construction. We're proud supporters of the Mustang Broncos. Go Broncos!
OKC, years in the making. The all-new Classic Chevrolet Northwest Expressway is finally here. Family-owned and operated, shop new Silverados. A massive $7,500 off MSRP. From the Stockyards to Bricktown, Paseo Arch to Midtown. Upgrade to a new Silverado. $7,500 off at the all-new Classic Chevrolet Northwest Expressway. This is OKC. This is Classic. Relax and enjoy the difference.
Understand that buying or selling your home isn't just a transaction, it's a journey. Because your dreams and your investments matter, I'm committed to working for you. With communication and integrity as my main priority, let me show you how I'm different. Liz Howerton Real Estate, making big moves.
Football there, football there, football everywhere. What? How is that a flag?
He landed on him after the sack. That's roughing the passer.
Huh. Okay, what if he hit him high?
Roughing the passer.
And low?
Roughing the passer.
Well, what if he couldn't stop his body like a human, so he ends up trampling him, and then he's like, oh no, and he tries to go back, and he tramples him some more, and he's like, I'm so sorry, I'm a buffalo. I don't know my strength compared to you.
Wait, what?
Come on, ref! Let the boys play!
Ladies and gentlemen, Cowboy Driving Academy welcomes you to another big night for the Mustang Broncos. Cowboy Driving Academy is Oklahoma's largest driving safety school. So when it's time to drive, it's time for Cowboy Driving Academy. Visit cowboydriving.com and register online for permits and driver safety classes and testing. If you're at least 15 years old, it's time to drive. And no one gets you driving more safely than Cowboy Driving Academy. Oklahoma's largest and most trusted driving school. Most permit applicants can even skip the written DPS test with Cowboy. Because we work 6 months ahead of schedule, Visit cowboydriving.com for details.
Discover authentic Italian cuisine at Emma L's in West OKC, featuring freshly prepared Italian favorites. Everything made to order. Dine in or get it to go. Emma L's Italian Kitchen, Kilpatrick Turnpike and 39th Expressway. Let us do the cooking.
Our mission here at Oral Surgery Specialists of Oklahoma is to provide exceptional care to our patients in a warm and welcoming environment.
We enjoy creating an exceptional experience for our patients with belief in patient education, careful listening, and customized treatment planning.
Here at Oral Surgery Specialists of Oklahoma, we uniquely offer a full scope of oral surgery and periodontal services under one roof, including dental implant placement, wisdom teeth removal, gum grafting, and jaw surgery.
We love what we do here, and we look forward to the opportunity to be able to care for our patients and provide exceptional oral surgery and periodontal surgery.
Hokie Print Barn is a proud sponsor of Mustang Athletics. For the best in custom apparel, contact Hokie Print Barn today. Hokie Print Barn, your hometown screen printer located on Highway 152 in Mustang. Let's go Broncos!
OU Health's ER and Urgent Care is now open with two convenient locations in both South Oklahoma City and Yukon. You get the convenience of an urgent care and all the expertise of an ER under one roof, and you only pay for the level of care you need. To learn more, visit www.ouhealth.com/oneroof. In network with most major insurance providers, including Medicare and Medicaid.
Joe Cooper Ford has 3 Ford dealerships around the metro to serve Oklahoma better than anyone else. What does having 3 of the best Ford dealerships in the state mean for you? That means 3 times the selection and 3 times the savings. And that's 3 times the service. And Joe guarantees to beat any price in Oklahoma by $500 or he'll give you $10,000. That's why Joe beats the competition 3-1. I love you, Oklahoma.
In Oklahoma City or the metro area, your stop for commercial and residential garage doors, garage door openers, and more, look no further than the incredible team at A-Plus Door and Gate. A-Plus Door and Gate, veteran-owned and operated.
Swadley's is serving up Oklahoma's favorite barbecue without ever leaving your car. That hot, tender, smoky goodness is ready for you to pick up in our drive-thru or convenient curbside service.
Hey, put it in the front seat, please.
We'll even serve your self-driving car.
Thank you.
So come on, we're Swadley's, world-famous barbecue, family-owned and operated.
If you want the real deal, call State Farm agent Drew Vincent in Edmond today.
Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there.
Even though our name has changed to Bank 7, the same friendly faces are here continuing to serve our community. We hope you'll come see us soon.
Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, here at halftime, and Mustang trails 35-23 to the two-time defending state champions, the Edmond North Huskies. And you saw why they are the two-time defending state champions there in that first half. So Mustang came out. Hey, they took some swings at the champ. They landed some body blows and got a couple headshots in. And I think all that really did was just got Edmond North woke up, because they came alive. And you have seen just how good they can be. Now, I know some of you are going to say, oh, probably sounding like, you know, just doing a little bit of whining, but I feel like it's been called two different games on each end of the court, the way it's been called. And a lot of that, you could, if you went back and looked at the number of free throws and things that were shot. But leading scorer for Edmond North, like most nights, Dylan Warlick with 11 points, and a lot of his coming from the free throw line, like I was just talking about. He's 5 of 5 from the free throw line. So, and then the 3 field goals. For Mustang, Miller, 4 points. Pogai, 5 points. So, again, it's just been a little bit of a struggle. And I think some of that is because at times, man, you just were surprised by what was called on one end and not the other. And then, who knows, maybe it's just the ends of the floor, because right there, I'll admit it, looked like Cole just kind of had it slip out of his hands as he went to make his spin move. But the foul was called, so Pogai gets it in there to Johnson. Jaden's got it. So Johnson, Miller, Pogai, and Clipson, the 5 on the floor to start things for Mustang. And I don't know, maybe I should have started talking about it the way I did, because a whistle and another foul. Tatum Ridge picks up that foul, his first second team foul. So quickly Mustang drawing a couple fouls. So Johnson, Pogai way outside. And the thing that's been hard for Pogai tonight is that long, rangy defenders that have been on him. But no problem right there for JT Johnson, as I believe he knocks down his 3rd triple of the night. He's got 9 points now. And Johnson is down as he was plowed. As he was plowed by Warlick. Half the gym screaming for a charge, the other half of the gym calling for a blocking foul. I'll let you decide which half of the gym is calling for each. But Johnson still doing his best to gather himself. He went down hard, just flat on his back. So Warlick got the 2 points. So Johnson has it, now gives it over to Miller. And thought about it for a second. Now Jaden will rise and fire. JT again, just off the mark. And then it's taken away as slipping to the floor was Tramble. And Johnson slips, and he has to just throw it up towards the rim. And transition basketball right there. Lots of passing, very little dribbling, and then Cole is going to be called for his 4th, I believe, if it's on Big Clip. Yep. Cole Clipson picks up his 4th. At the 6:15 mark of the 3rd quarter, so Cole's probably going to have to sit, and that'll make it a little more difficult for Mustang as they lose some size down low. So Michael Vincent checks in. And
how many fouls on Michael?
So Vincent will check in. He's only got 1 foul. So, you know, it's tough to play both those guys at the same time, because you'd hate for them to, you know, both kind of get into foul trouble when you've really just got to kind of replace one with the other. So it's a 13-point game. Roman up top. Guarded out there by Tramble. Looking to get into the lane. Flips that one up and it goes. Splits the trio of Wolves, or of Huskies that had surrounded him. And that's Roman's first field goal tonight. His 4 points had all come from the free throw line. Pot spins into the lane, little baby hook up and in. Bryce Potts puts that one away. So again, Mustang's gonna have to get some stops, whistle and a foul, as Pogai does exactly what he should, goes right into the body of the defender. We've seen guys from Edmond North, you see it all the time. I mean, that's what they're taught to do, go right into them. More often than not, you're gonna get that foul call. So Tyson will go to the free throw line. Knocks that one in. Reyes will check in, and JT will go to the bench, and he's going to get checked out. I can see him kind of going back up in the tunnel just a little bit, again, as he just got smacked into on the front side by a big, strong young man in Dylan Warlick, and then just landed right on that hip bone, I think they're on that left side. Quick release three is up and in for number three, Dontrell Yearby. So Yearby answers back for North. Miller looks to drive, and anywhere he goes, there's one right on him and another one not far away. Pogai again trying to go to work down low. Flips that one up. Back rim won't go. But Vincent is fouled as he's knocked to the floor getting after another rebound. And that's what we saw out of Big Michael last night when we needed it down the stretch to hold on to that 54-50 win. So Ridge picks up his second foul. Roman, a little shake and bake three, won't go. Reyes doing his best job to try and keep that one alive. Unfortunately, his momentum was carrying him the wrong way and he knocks it back over his head. And I guess I can be quiet about the free throw shooting. I was sitting there complaining about it at the beginning of the half, and then they just gave me the stats to this point right now. Air ball off the hands of Tramble. Yeah, they just gave it to me now. Mustang, 8 of 8 from the free throw line. Edmond North, 8 of 8 from the free throw line. So, all right, I'll let it go. JT checks back in. Reyes will go to the bench, so JT seems like he's going to be all right. A little dribble weave action up top, passing it around, just looking for a lane, looking for some kind of opening. Roman comes all the way across from one side to the other, and then he's bumped up top and off to the races as Yearby. And Roman really challenges, thought maybe we were going to get a foul, didn't. But Ridge gets the putback basket. And a Jay Willis auto body full timeout is taken. So with this one, again, starting to kind of slip away just ever so slightly. 46-30, Edmond North on top.
Football there, football there, football everywhere. What? How is that a flag?
He landed on him after the sack. That's roughing the passer.
Huh. Okay, what if he hit him high?
Roughing the passer.
And low?
Roughing the passer.
Well, what if he couldn't stop his body like a human, so he ends up trampling him, and then he's like, oh, no, and he tries to go back, and he tramples him some more, and he's like, I'm so sorry, I'm a buffalo. I don't know my strength compared to you.
Wait, what?
Come on, ref, let the boys play.
Just saw that commercial for Buffalo Wild Wings, and man, some of that sounds good right now. That's for sure. I could take me some bone-in medium with a little bit of ranch on the side. Bless is saying, no, 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 you got to go with the boneless. Too much breading, not enough chicken. So, but 46-30, Mustang trailing here in this one. And again, just like the previous two games against these guys, just nothing easy. Having to basically work overtime just to try to get a little bit of something. Rotate it down, three ball on the way, off the mark. This time JT can't connect. And again, great transition basketball once again by North, off and running. Don't waste any time dribbling, just pass it up the floor. And Pogai is going to pick up the foul. His first, team second here in the third quarter. Jay Willis Auto Body is the sponsor of all Mustang Bronco timeouts. And that last one was probably much needed, kind of try to slow down Edmond North. So here in the Together We Church third quarter with just about three minutes left. Hey, new name but same support of Mustang Athletics, formerly Trinity Baptist Church. Three ball right on cue. Talking about Together We Church third quarter. And JT Johnson's got 12 points now, and they've all come from long range. So trying to keep Mustang as close as possible, but Together We Church, the official sponsor of all Bronco third quarters. Together We Church is still reaching, discipling, sending. Together we are Broncos. And on the drive by Ridge. On the drive by Ridge, they're going to get Jaden Johnson with that foul. He picks up his third team, and at the free throw line will be senior Tatum Ridge. Drops that one through. Again, you drop this one here tonight and not all is lost. It just makes it a little bit more difficult. So the loser of this game will have to travel down to Lawton on Saturday for either a 6:30 or a 7:30 game and would play the winner of the Northwest Classen Putnam City North elimination game that's going on down there this evening. That three just a little bit short. Vincent with the big rebound. Tried to put the scoop shot up. Warlick came down across his arms. And now finally a foul as Roman is tangled up inside a trio of Huskies. Fitzgerald picks up his second foul, and that's the fifth, so Miller will go to the free throw line. Again, yeah, the loser of this game will be playing in an elimination game. Saturday against, as Miller shoots free throws, gets the first one to go, second one as well. And at last check, it says Putnam City North was up 55-54 in the fourth quarter, but that update was quite a while ago, so we'll have to see if we can find a score on that game. And there's a case where Warlick had just made up his mind he was going to get to his spot and put up a shot. He did just that, and he's fouled. Vincent picks up his second. And the fourth team foul. And Coach Hodges has just been teed up. He had had enough of what he felt was some inconsistent officiating. And Coach Hodges goes ahead and he'll take one for the team. And right on cue to go along with my comment, the Edmond North student section starts chanting, "This is our house." So, you know, there's all the conspiracy theorists in college basketball that think KU at home gets all the calls. Well, not sure what the delay is here in Warlick finishing the free throw shooting, but nope, Coach Hodges, go ahead. He'd had enough, wanted to finish voicing his opinion on the matter, and he was issued the technical, so. And now the official along the baseline. And the two coaches, I think, are kind of starting to have some words. Because the Edmond North coach, he's hot about something. I think Coach Hodges had an issue with the fact that it looked like Coach Norris was encouraging the student section to continue their harassment of Coach Hodges. And then Coach Hodges, I think, so kind of try to get things to. And there you can hear the Edmond North student section continuing to, I think they were telling Coach Hodges to go start the bus. And it looks like, or I say it should feel like, just looking at both sides between the student section, who now, I don't know if you can see it in yours, yeah, we had some, had a couple of students there on the end. Yeah, guys, I would turn that camera just to yeah. If you can, okay, good, yeah, I just, no, there's some annex in the student section there at the end that are good outside of our camera view, that are outside of our camera view that we don't want being seen from the Edmond North student section. Say some not suitable for television hand gestures and things. So Warlick misses that free throw, and I'm not sure how many free throws we're going to have. I guess those were the two that Warlick was awarded on the foul, and now Tramble will go to the free throw line, I believe, and shoot. Possibly could be up to four technicals as Coach Hodges was ushered out of the building, or at least off the court. So second one is up and good. And so they're just those two. So, all right, after all that was said and done, Edmond North has the basketball, and they're up 52-35. So just a chaotic series of events. I think if Warlick had knocked down that corner three, this place would have erupted like Vesuvius. Miller just inside the three-point line, won't go. Vincent fights for a rebound. And then he is fouled. So that's going to be on Knoll.
Husky foul on number 22, Logan Knoll. Second personal.
Knoll picks up his second foul. Fifth team foul, so Michael will shoot two.
Number 32, Bryce Potts, checking into the game.
So Potts back in as Knoll will take a seat. Vincent knocks down both of his free throws. So I believe Mustang still perfect from the line tonight. As we're under a minute and a half to play, three-pointer up, off the rim, won't go. Vincent applies just enough pressure to Warlick that he forces Warlick to travel. Three-pointer up and good by Tyson Pogai. And that gives the Mustang faithful something to cheer about, as it's been a little while since we've had a field goal. Again, and there's been a lot of action on the court and on the sidelines here in this Together We Church third quarter. Johnson gambles, goes after that one. And a couple of head and shoulder fakes and then getting some guys up in the air and then going to the line after he's fouled will be Bryce Potts. Pogai picks up his second. Potts off the mark on that one. Yeah, and it's still, I mean, it's only a 12-point game, and Mustang, they can light it up from outside. The problem is they just haven't been able to get many looks at it. So outside of JT Johnson, who has hit four threes, he's got 12. Tyson just hit one a minute ago. Just long, rangy, athletic defenders in your face every time you look to put the ball up. Tyson drives, count it, and one opportunity. So the three-pointer's not there. Hey, just drive it and do it the old-fashioned way. Fouls on Yearby. So Yearby picks up his second, and Tyson will go to the free throw line, and if he can knock this down, it'll be a 10-point game with just about 20 seconds left in the third. So in 8 minutes. Still to come here in the fourth quarter. Down low it goes. Again, as Johnson slips and falls, and then trying to get past him is Fitzgerald, and Fitzgerald trips over him. Jaden Johnson picks up his fourth. And again, that was all just because Johnson going 90 miles an hour lost his footing and went down. So Johnson will step in. Fitzgerald at the line all by himself. Rattles that one in. And that one around and down it goes. So back to a 12-point game. Just about 3 seconds. Roman rises, fires. Had a good look at it. Couldn't get it to fall from long distance. And if the fourth quarter is anything like the third quarter, man, we are in for something else. So 55-43, Mustang trails Edmond North as we get ready to head to the final 8 minutes of this one. We'll take a timeout and be back with more Bronco basketball in just a couple minutes.
Two is better than one. Well, when it comes to the best new Ram truck deals in Oklahoma, Joe Cooper guarantees it. Get twice the selection, twice the savings, twice the service. We guarantee to beat any deal in a new Ram truck by $500, or we'll give you $10,000. That's why Joe beats the competition 2-1. Who loves you, Oklahoma? Joe Cooper Ram in Shawnee and UConn.
Back to action here at Edmond North. Final 8 minutes. If Mustang's going to make a move, they're going to have to get it started here now as they are down by 12. And nice defensive pressure by Michael Vincent along the baseline to force Potts to step out of bounds. So a quick turnover. And now somebody from the Edmond North student section being escorted out by a couple of Edmond's finest. Three-pointer up on the way and in. Again, Tyson Pogai is not going to show any emotion, just ice in his veins. So, and that cuts it down to a 9-point game. Again, as much of a just as much of a mess as it's been at times for Mustang. They're right here in this one late. Driving in, Vincent with the rebound. Johnson has it. So again, nice challenge. Michael did a great job to stay straight up. So Roman has it, directing traffic. He'll look to go. Spins into the lane, stops. And he's bumped. I think it's number 20, Jonathan Van Buren, who has checked in. And he will come out. And Dontrell Yearby back in. Vincent up top. Johnson, I think everybody in the gym knew he was going to try to get that one back to Pogai. I believe it was Ridge, just stuck a hand out, knocked it out. So Mustang will now inbound there on the sideline. Vincent comes and gets it. Roman calls him out. Passes up on the screen. Free throw line. Johnson drives, puts up a tough one. Can't get it to go, but a reach-in foul on the shot is going to be on Ridge. Husky foul number one, Ridge. And Johnson will go to the free throw line. Jaden. First one. Around and in, and then get some encouragement from his imaginary friend standing there behind him. As that one, basically the same thing. So it's a 7-point game. Edmond North was threatening to just absolutely run away with this one after all the technicals and everything. And again, Johnson falls there on the floor. Drive down the lane, flips it up and in, does Tramble. So there's a spot there on the left side of the Edmond North floor that must be a little bit slick. I've seen a couple guys. Johnson down the lane, floater up and in. So JT, he's got 4 threes, and now that runner in the lane, I believe he's 14 points for JT tonight, so good night for him. And again, down on the floor is Johnson. Miller skies in for that rebound. Nobody blocked him out. He was able to snake his way through. He tries to spin down into the lane. Up off the glass, too strong. Vincent had a good look at it, but his shot caroms off the glass. And Roman just bats that one away. You would have liked to have seen if he could have got a better grasp on it, but knocks it out. So North will inbound. Down in the corner, Yearby. Warlick posting up down low, spins around Vincent, and he's going to pick up the foul. Warlick will go to the line once again. So Michael Vincent picks up his third. Warlick good on that one again. Second one is good as well, so that pushes it back up to 9. Still single digits, just under 5 to play here in this one. Again, the winner here moves on in area. The loser's got to try to win one more to get to that point. Roman lost it off his leg for a second. Step back three, got it. Jaden Johnson knocks down a triple and a timeout taken from the bench. A Jay Willis auto body 30-second timeout. We'll step aside as well, give everybody a chance to catch their breath as Mustang is right back in this one, down six.
OKC, years in the making. The all-new Classic Chevrolet Northwest Expressway is finally here. Family-owned and operated, shop new Silverados. A massive 7,500 off MSRP. From the Stockyards to Bricktown, Paseo Arch to Midtown. Upgrade to a new Silverado, 7,500 off at the all-new Classic Chevrolet Northwest Expressway. This is OKC. This is Classic. Relax and enjoy the difference.
Back to action here in the News Channel 4, the Oklahoma News 4 fourth quarter with 4:38 left to go on the big board here in Edmond. So just a little over 4 minutes to play in Oklahoma News Channel 4, the official sponsor of all Bronco fourth quarters. News Channel 4, Oklahoma's source for all breaking news, streaming live video, traffic, sports, and severe weather coverage. KFOR looking out for you. Mustang down six. And again, great ball movement.
Number 32, Bryce Potts.
Great ball movement. Gets Potts a wide open look there at the rim, and he's not going to miss many of those. He lays that one up and in. And free throw disparity starting to show up again here. At one point, it was tied 8-8. Both teams had shot 8 and made 8. Mustang, 15 of 15 from the line. Edmond North, 20 of 25. So 40 free throws have been shot between the two teams. So Vincent challenging for that rebound, knocks it out of bounds, and he will catch a breather as Clipson will check back in. Cole has spent extended minutes on the bench as he's got four fouls. So, and we're under four to play. And Edmond North has not been pushed many times like this year, so we'll see. And down low it goes to Warlick, dribbles it off his leg, spins back to his left and puts it up and in. So Warlick gets that one to go, and the lead back to double digits at 10 now. Quick release, three, off the front of the rim, won't go. Pogai had it for a second, but it was knocked away from him. I believe it went off of Ridge of Edmond North, so Mustang will keep it. And still time to go, three minutes and change. So, and Roman has had Keontae Tramble in his back pocket. Everywhere Roman's tried to go, Keontae's been right there. Fadeaway turnaround jumper by Tyson just off the mark. Couldn't secure it, so Clipson was able to come in and get it from Ridge. Three on the way off the mark. Rebound, and I think that's going to do it for Cole. Yeah, Cole kind of got hooked in on Potts. And Cole will have a seat, so Michael Vincent will have to come back in. And if Mustang's going to pull off the big-time upset here tonight with 2:40 left to go, they're going to have to do it without the big man down low, Cole Clipson. Irby has to chase that one down as that passes off the mark just a little bit. A timeout is taken by Edmond North as Potts had gotten down low. But Vincent had done a nice job forcing him kind of back behind the goal a little bit. And coach is going to call a timeout. So we will step aside as well for another Jay Willis auto body timeout.
Swadley's is serving up Oklahoma's favorite barbecue without ever leaving your car. That hot, tender, smoky goodness is ready for you to pick up in our drive-thru or convenient curbside service.
Hey, put it in the front seat, please.
We'll even serve your self-driving car.
Thank you.
So come on, we're Swadley's World Famous Barbecue, family owned and operated.
Jay Willis Auto Body in Mustang and North OKC, a full-service auto body shop. And in less time than it takes for a timeout, their team of experts can get you back on the road. Check them out online, jaywillisautobody.com. Edmond North up by 10, 2.5 minutes. They're not going to rush anything on the offensive side. So, again, Mustang can gamble a little bit on the fouls. And then, again, good interior passing. And Potts puts that one down. Bogai looks to drive. His follow-away jumper along the baseline is good. So Tyson Pogai gets that one to go. Tyson's kind of heated up here a little bit in the second half. So Warlick gets it on the run, spins into the lane, kicks it way back out as we're under two, and it's a 10-point game. But, yeah, Tyson here in the second half, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. So he's got 18 overall, 13 here in the second half. So he's come alive a little bit. But, again, Mustang cannot mess around. They've got to make something happen and in a hurry as they're down to about a minute and a half, trailing by 10. Pogai again, same shot, other side. That one pinballs out. And Warlick gets the rebound. But hey, even if this one doesn't wind up going Mustang's way, you got to give them credit. Edmond North was primed to just blow this one out of the water. Roman not going to quit fighting. He's going to go and is clobbered on his way to the hoop. So like Tramble picks that one up. But, yeah, Edmond North was in, like I said, prime position to just – run away and hide with this one and not give Mustang a chance. But Broncos continue to keep firing just like that. Tipped around. Vincent comes up with it. Up and under. Has it knocked away as he goes up. Kicks it out. Three on the corner. Off the mark. Warlick has it. And we're down under a minute to play. And Johnson gets in the way of big Bryce Potts just enough to cause him to miss that one. Scoop shot up and in. Count it by Tyson Pogai. Beautiful move. And the fancy finish. And Tyson will go to the free throw line. So, but again, Mustang was in danger of basically getting run out of the gym, but they weren't going to let that happen. A lot of fireworks there in the third quarter. Tyson knocks that one down for the three-point play, and it's a six-point game, 65-59. Again, Mustang got to take some chances and hopefully not give up anything. Tyson's going to jump in, foul. So that's going to be the fourth, so the next one will send Edmond North to the free throw line. But you got to like the heart. You got to like the fight that Mustang showed all night long here tonight when, again, they could have just packed it in and said, hey, we've got more to, more to play. We can just let this one go. But they definitely did not want to do that. So that's the fifth foul. So that one now is going to send Tramble to the free throw line. That one crawls over the front rim and goes in. One of the officials goes over to the scorer's table to check and see. Well, not sure what that was about, but one more for Tramble. So he drops that one in. And for some reason, Coach Norris wants a timeout. So It's a full timeout, so we'll step aside. Again, 26.9 exactly on the board. Mustang trailing by 9 here in this one. Back with more Bronco basketball in just a moment.
Our mission here at Oral Surgery Specialists of Oklahoma is to provide exceptional care to our patients in a warm and welcoming environment.
We enjoy creating an exceptional experience for our patients with belief in patient education, careful listening, and customized treatment planning.
Here at Oral Surgery Specialists of Oklahoma, we uniquely offer a full scope of oral surgery and periodontal services under one roof, including dental implant placement, wisdom teeth removal, gum grafting, and jaw surgery.
Edmond North was done well before that timeout was, so our apologies to Oral Surgery Specialists of Oklahoma. They are outstanding sponsors. You can check them out online at OklahomaCityOralSurgery.com. So best oral surgeons and periodontists in the business, Oklahoma City, or Oklahoma Oral Surgery Specialists of Oklahoma. Tyson gets that one to go. Johnson, one Johnson tried to steal it, couldn't get it. The other Johnson is going to foul Warlick, and he will make the long walk to the other end of the floor. Again, with his team up 7 and only 10 seconds left to go. So it looks like Mustang is going to play tomorrow evening down in Lawton. And again, it'll depend on how many games are going on. It'll be either 6:30 or 7:30. So as soon as we get that game time, we will make sure and get it out on at MHS Broncos Sports on Twitter. So there you can see it on the screen. But make sure, if you don't already follow that, make sure you do, because all the latest up-to-date information, game times, and opponents will be posted there. But again, it'll either be Putnam City North or Northwest Klassen. Poguys 3 bounces off the rim up and over the goal. And with less than a second on the clock, Edmond North is going to move on in area, or move on to area. Mustang still has a chance to get there, but they've got to defeat either Northwest Klassen or Putnam City North tomorrow night, as, again, can't get a final on that score. Everything that I see still says 55-54 Putnam City North in the fourth quarter, so don't know how that one has finished up. But, again, Mustang will take on one of those two teams tomorrow night down in Lawton, and we will have it live for you here on MHSBroncosports.tv. So, hey, it's been a day. We'll just go ahead and say that. We started 3:30 over in UConn, and we saw the girls get a big 48-42 victory over the rival UConn Millers on UConn's home court to punch their ticket to the area round of the state tournament. So, and then the guys put up a good fight here tonight, but came up just a little bit short down the stretch. And you look at Edmond North's schedule, there are not very many teams that have stayed within 8 points of these guys, especially with some hardware on the line. That is for sure. So some final stats here tonight before we get out of here. But yeah, Dylan Warlick, again, just an incredible night. 22 points for him. Tramble with 11. Ridge with 12. For Mustang, Miller, 8 points, 2 rebounds, 2 assists. Poguy came alive in that second half. Finishes with 23 points and then deuces across the board. 2 rebounds, 2 assists, and 2 steals. And again, Michael Vincent, another big night with Cole Clipson in foul trouble. But Michael, doing all he could down low, finishes 6 points and 8 rebounds. So Mustang still alive, a chance to move on, but they've got to win tomorrow night. They lose that one, and they are done for the season. So, again, we'll have it for you. And, again, make sure you check at MHS Bronco Sports on Twitter. Again, once those game times are announced, looks like it'll either be 6:30 or 7:30. Again, it just depends on what other games are being played down in Lawton. But we'll be on the road once again and have it all for you. So, hey, we appreciate you joining us tonight. We look forward to having you with us live on air tomorrow night as Mustang looks to try and advance into area down in the regional consolation bracket. So we appreciate Southwest Cleaning Services for being our post-game sponsor each and every Bronco basketball game. You can contact the outstanding people at Southwest Cleaning Services. See how they can help you and your business with all your janitorial and commercial cleaning needs. You can visit them online at southwestcleaningservices.net or give them a call, 405-314-1977. So until tomorrow night, hey, we'll go ahead and put this one to bed and hope that you have a great rest of your evening, a blessed tomorrow, and as always, go Broncos!